Welcome to TimeBeat Breaking News Channel. Here are our breaking news today.
1. Nearly 250 people were detained during a pipeline protest in Minnesota. 2. During demolition, a building in South Korea collapses onto a bus.
The United States. Nearly 250 people were detained during a pipeline protest in Minnesota. Protesters aiming to halt the final part of an oil pipeline restoration project in northwestern Minnesota seized over a pump station, resulting in over 250 arrests, according to law enforcement authorities. Hubbard County Sheriff Corey Ox said that 43 workers at the Enbridge Energy Line 3 pump station were trapped inside the site for some time Monday morning when demonstrators locked them in behind the front gate. Protesters also put up barricades and dug trenches across roads, presumably in preparation for a standoff with law enforcement, Ox said. This is unacceptable, and we will seek the full prosecution of all involved, Enbridge Energy spokeswoman Julie Kellner said. 179 people were arrested and charged with gross misdemeanor trespassing. An additional 68 people were cited for public nuisance and unlawful assembly. It was the largest show of resistance since protesters set their sights on the project. Vandalism to contractor equipment includes slashed tires, damaged hoses, pebbles and dirt in engines, forced entrance into offices, and equipment with ruined electrical wiring. She didn't provide a cost estimate for the damage. Demonstrators hauled in a large boat to block the main entrance to the pumping station, and about 20 people barricaded themselves to it. By midday Tuesday, the remaining four protesters had been removed off the boat, and Kellner said some personnel had returned to work at the facility in Park Rapids, some 85 miles east of Fargo.
South Korea. During demolition, a building in South Korea collapses onto a bus. According to South Korea's Ministry of the Interior and Safety, at least 9 persons were murdered when a 5-story structure that was being demolished crashed onto a bus on Wednesday. The bus, which was stopped on a major route at the time, was buried in the rubble near Gwangju, some 270 kilometers, 168 miles, southwest of Seoul. A further 25 people were injured, including 8 seriously, the ministry added. The 16 demolition workers on the site are safe and did not sustain any injuries as the building collapsed. Approximately 190 firefighters were deployed for search and rescue, and police joined the rescue effort, the ministry said. The reason for the collapse was unclear, citing officials at the Gwangju Fire and Safety Headquarters. The Ministry of Land, Infrastructure and Transport will investigate the cause of the collapse.
Thank you for watching. We help you stay up to date all the news hourly. Please subscribe our channel to follow up the latest one.